Welcome back to Metal Injection's Countdown. On this edition, we'll be revisiting the most shocking moments in heavy metal history. From murders and lawsuits to animal decapitation, our esteemed panel of metalheads will look back at the 10 most controversial moments in metal.
Guns N' Roses have packed a whole career of controversy into just one tour. The Guns N' Roses Metallica shows have not gone off without a hitch. There have been riots, legal hassles, and technical problems.
The 92 GNR riot. The second of, I believe, four career riots for Axl Rose.
Probably the biggest metal tour of all time. It was Guns N' Roses, Metallica doing a co-headlining tour.
Metallica comes out to play, and their pyro guy, whose name, by the way, was Shaky, which is kind of like, you know, hiring a gynecologist named Pokey. Like, it's just, I don't know what the fuck you're thinking.
He came in and said, okay, the fade to black stuff is gonna be out on the wings, so don't go out there. I said, okay. But he didn't specify that it was in addition to what's already there. So I walked from the wings right onto where one of them was and just...
That was the night that James Hetfield got scorched by pyro. He had to be rushed off stage, taken to the hospital. He had all sorts of skin burns, and he obviously, you know, the band stopped the show.
Hetfield was taken to a nearby hospital for treatment.
There was an incident with the pyrotechnics. Unfortunately, James is on his way to the hospital right now, and we're very sorry, but we can't continue the concert for you guys tonight.
You would think that Guns N' Roses would play the hero and come out and maybe start on time for once, you know, maybe play a longer set, but, you know, they start late, crowd gets restless, then they cut their set short because Axl supposedly has a problem with his voice.
You know, this is in the height of Axl's ego.
We had just stopped the tour because I had throat problems. Came back and I realized I'm going to hurt myself.
Right.
I told Slash two more songs. If we can't get it fixed, I got to go. You know? And then we did more than two more songs. And finally, I was just kind of like, I don't know what to do.
Guns N' Roses come out and just be sweet. But then Axl's like, no, I have an idea. I'm gonna fucking ruin this.
Axl Rose is a genius in two ways. One, getting attention for himself, and two, controlling through absence. He knows that the best way to keep himself in the spotlight is not to be there. It's why he's constantly late for shows. It's why he takes decades to put out albums. The best thing Axl Rose can do is not be there if he wants to make sure everyone's talking about him. So James Hetfield dares to be the star of the show that night by being turned into a human shish kebab. And what does Axl Rose decide to do? Oh, he's gonna complain that his voice is fucked up and walk off the stage.
I think at the very least, he could have given it more than he did, which was not even an hour. You know, and these are fans that paid a lot of money to see these two bands, basically ending up barely seeing either one of them. So they were pissed. And they rioted.
They blew into the Canadian provincial capital of Montreal on Saturday night and ended in a riot after Metallica frontman James Hetfield was sent to the hospital with exploding pyrotechnic injuries, and Guns frontman Axl Rose abruptly ended his band's set with some ominous comments about the band's future. At least 8 police and 10 concertgoers sustained minor injuries in the melee that followed. A dozen arrests were made, and initial reports estimated damage to the stadium to nearby stores to total as much as $1 million.
I think the craziest part of the story is that we're talking about Canadians, the sweetest people on earth, who say sorry because they apologize too much. You ever wonder how to piss off a Canadian? You give them Axl Rose.
Slash and Duff and them were like, man, these Canadians are pretty well-mannered. And Axl's like, no, wait, watch, check this out. Watch.
That was just so selfish, especially probably what Metallica was going through back there.
Quit being a baby, you know, just go out there and just do it, just for the sake of rock, for, your band, for Metallica, for the fans.
He could have saved the day and like put on a great show and sent fans home happy, even though there was this shitty thing that happened before it. But instead, he was like, you know what? I'd rather be a diva.
Axel Pose, dressing room requirements. Absolutely no substitutions. One cup of cubed ham, not fucking, you know, it's got to be cubed up fucking right so it'll get down his little neck.
They do a lot of bitching for a band who got paid about 20-30% more than fucking what they deserved at a show because they didn't bring that much. Ooh, Axel's talking now. Well, listen to that. He's, who's he think he is?
People got hurt. People were arrested. I mean, some people's lives probably changed that day because of the riot and the accident that happened. I don't know, man. It's just a dick move. And rock bands, any musician should never do that to their fans, man. Without their fans, musicians and artists are shit. They're nothing.
It's good now that I think in the metal scene that you wouldn't have many artists whatsoever who would do that. Who would even think to do that? Like I said, they would do the opposite. They're going to play their hearts out. Don't forget to call my lawyer.